body. And welcome to today's video. Today I'm here with my lovely friend Christina, and we're here together for a little hair care session. And hair play session. Usually, when I say I want to do a specific thing, like brush someone's hair, or give them a massage, etc., I like to intuitively listen to what their body reflects back to me. And also allow my movements to happen naturally. So even though I would like to brush her hair, I may also take a moment to give some attention to other parts if I feel like they need the attention. Christina's hair looks really pretty and healthy. It feels strong in my hands. And when we spoke about meeting for this session, I asked her what she wanted to do, and she preferred the hair thing first. Which made me really happy. As some of you might know, hair care and hair brushing is one of my favorite triggers and videos to make and also to watch. So I'm going to start with my little spray. If you watch the videos, you know it is a homemade spray, water-based with peppermint and eucalyptus essential oil. Which I like to use in the beginning and the end of my videos so I can bring the awareness in the present moment, clear the air around us, and set my intentions for the specific session. So now that I have done this, I will take the little brush . Always when I'm brushing someone's hair, I like to start from the bottom and make my way up. I find that that way there is a better release of knots. Be present. I find in my personal experience, if I start right away from the top and the hair is really tangled, it will create a big knot somewhere in the middle, and it will be really painful to get rid of. So by doing it this way, I have already detangled the bottom, so I just go at the top and the brush just flows through smoothly. And with no pain. I will do the other side. Like I suspected, she has beautiful, healthy hair, indeed. And it's really easy and soft to brush through it. I'm careful not to go at the front too much because she has cute bangs that I don't want to mess with. I just like to play with her hair a little bit. I'm gonna split it in the middle. Very softly. And I'm just gonna braid her hair. I always enjoy working with different hair textures. And Christina's hair is a little bit wavy and curly at some parts. So I'm really careful when brushing it, not to create any split ends or hurt the hair. it in a little ponytail, I think, as well. Maybe make her a little ponytail too, and in a nice little braid like this. To be honest, I don't think I've ever seen her hair in a high pony. I think it looks really, really pretty. Before I release it and finish off, now that I have freed up her neck, I would like to focus a little bit on this area. Just giving her gentle squeezes. Trying to add to the relaxation and catch any stray tensions. Better on the ears. The side. And some gentle pulls. tingles at the hair. Of course, applying minimal force. Can be their own form of a massage. And really release the tiny tensions and the stress that is trapped in a lot of the areas of our heads. And to finish off, I would like to use my comb to comb through her hair. As I reach toward her scalp, I'm going to do another one of my preferred techniques. Which is to use this specific comb a little bit as a massage gua sha tool and just apply minimal force but really try to create some friction on all the tiny muscles and energy passes and paths that flow through the head. To ensure as much as I can that I alleviated the tension. Thank you so much for joining us today. And for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Hope you can find a few moments in your day to do something nice for yourself.